Reprogramming Earth is an exhibition about the impact of human intervention on the planet. The exhibition specifically explores the dual and ambiguous role of technology in the era of climate crisis. Nowadays, we realize that on one hand, the environmental issues that we are all experienced have to a great extent been caused by the advance and the use of technology, and on the other hand, we expect to find solutions to the problems, to these issues, by the field of technology again. So there is, in a way, this controversy. To be more specific, one could here possibly refer to some examples that are common and familiar to all of us. For instance, the devices that we're all using nowadays, demand for their manufacturing, the mining of rare earth materials, the constant connectivity and the use of streaming or the use of teleconferencing that we are enjoying nowadays has to do with the great power consumption. And something else, of course, is the fact that the devices that we no longer use, the devices that we dump, are causing toxic waste and pollution to the environment. Now, having this in mind, the question is to which extent technology can offer solutions, to which extent technology can offer, let's say, radical solutions. The title of exhibition, Reprogramming Earth, exactly refers to this. What does it mean to engineer, to reprogram the planet? What does it mean to think that the human always has the possibility to do this, to control Earth and its ecosystems? How arrogant, if I can say, such belief is, and what will it take at the end to realize, to acknowledge the impact of human intervention on the environment? The exhibition presents the implications, the ecological implications, but it also critically reflects upon, let's say, the technological-driven solutions that are being discussed nowadays. So, for instance, some of the works refer to the new forms of extractivism that are being discussed nowadays. They refer to the problematics of the disposable digital culture, while others more, let's say, point towards the limitations of solutions like the one of geoengineering or seed bombing. The works very much emphasize how soil, air and water are themselves, in a way, living technologies, living infrastructures that we all depend upon. What is also interesting to notice is that the protagonists in some of the works are not humans, but rather entities from the more than human world. Overall, I would say that the Reprogramming the Earth exhibition aims to overcome common progress narratives and to rather find perspectives from within the Earth's live worlds. And this is something that is being, let's say, done purposefully in order to find again the forgotten or the broken, let's say, bonds between us and the environment, between us and the living worlds around us.